So it's been officially 1 year since Church Boy Production Studio has been streaming at the gates. And listen, what an incredible journey thus far. It takes an incredible team to put on a great stream. From the producer to the editor to the cameraman and sound engineers. And how can I forget the incredible praise team?
Once Oral do the zip, I got Donald do a pick it on back on the drums like normal.
It's energy, practice, practice, and more practice, discipline, prayer, camaraderie. We love it.
We are family. We keep tight. We love each other. We love the Lord. And we're putting this on for you, but we're also putting this on most definitely for the glory of God.
Even though we may set plans, but sometimes the enemy try and mess up plans, but sometimes you have a plan B, and God helps us through everything. I have an excellent set of young people that I'm working with. Not perfect, no group is perfect, but we are able to work together because we love God and we are a family and we believe in giving God first our best.
You gotta be graced for this.
Good morning, everyone. This is Golden Gates World Outreach Ministries, and I'm Pastor Trent. We thank you for joining us this morning online for our morning communion worship service. This first Sunday sets us off on a path to end the year strong. We're happy that you're with us, and the countdown for service to begin has already started. We will join the service in just a few moments. But as you remain prayerful in anticipation of the word, do us a kind favor. And share this broadcast with all of your friends, all of your groups on WhatsApp, or even on Facebook. Let's be cyber evangelists. Again, welcome to the service, and let's expect God to do great things.
Yes, Lord. Oh, giving you honor, giving you all of the glory, giving you all of the praise, Lord. In all things, we thank you, Lord Jesus. We give you praise on the mountaintop. We give you praise in the valley, Lord. Oh, we lift your name on high. Your name is worthy to be praised. Oh, we lift up the name of Jesus, our mighty Lord and Savior. Oh, we thank you, Lord, today. Lord, you are glorified, Lord. You are lifted up this morning, Lord. Oh, we praise you, Lord. We thank you for all that you've done for us, Lord. We thank you for all that you're going to do for us today, Lord Jesus. Oh, Heavenly Father, we give you praise. We lift up your name. We give you honor. We give you glory. We give you praise, Lord Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus, for keeping us this week, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for providing for us this week, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for keeping us out of the snares of the enemy this week, Lord. Oh, we give you praise. We give you honor, we give you glory, Lord. Oh, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Oh, Father, your name is worthy. Your name is worthy. Oh, we bow down before you, Lord, and we worship you, Lord. Oh, we give you glory, we give you praise this morning, Lord Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you. We give you praise. Lord, we give you honor, we give you glory, we magnify your name, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, Heavenly Father, Lord, now we ask, Lord, that your anointing rest in this place, Lord Jesus. Oh, you send your Holy Spirit to abide with us, Lord. Father, we're inviting your presence today, Lord. Father, we're inviting your Lordship today, Lord. Oh, set yourself among us, Lord, this morning, Lord. Oh, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, we give you glory, we give you praise, we give you honor this morning, Lord Jesus. Oh, Father, now we ask that we come looking for a word today, Lord Jesus. Oh, an unadulterated word today, Lord. Oh, send your word, Lord. Send your word, Lord Jesus. Oh, and Father, we ask that, Lord, that you rest upon your manservant today that will be delivering the word, Lord. Oh, Heavenly Father, Lord, speak through him, Lord Jesus. Oh, and anoint him, Lord Jesus, that your word will go God the land, Lord Jesus. And you will be praised, and you will be glorified, and you will be lifted up on high, Lord Jesus. Now, Father, we come against anything that is unlike you this morning. Anything that is unlike you, send it back to the pits of hell from whence it cometh, Lord Jesus. And your name and your word will be glorified. Your name will be lifted up. Your name will be praised and honored this morning, Lord. Oh, we give you glory. We give you praise. We give you honor, Lord Jesus. And we magnify your name. And we lift your name up on high. Father, we thank you for your son, Jesus, who died on the cross, that we may have life and that we may have it more abundantly, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Oh, and Heavenly Father, we ask that you once again set yourself in this place and your anointing rest upon us. And we give you praise. We give you honor. We give you all of the glory. In your precious and holy name we pray. Amen.
Morning, church. Scripture reading is taken from Isaiah, the 53rd chapter, verses 1 through 9. Who hath believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant and as a root out of a ground. He hath no form, no comeliness. And when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and we hid it as we our faces from him, and he was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord had laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed, he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is bought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before our shears is dumb, so we opened it not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment, and who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of the living. For the transgression of my people was he stricken. And he made his grave with the wicked, and with the rich in his death, because he had done no violence, neither was any deceit in his mouth. Hands the word of the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
What an awesome God we serve. What an amazing King. What a wonderful Savior. Hallelujah. Well, our Redeemer, our Waymaker, our Deliverer,
yes.
Our Salvation, the one who saves, the one who heals, the one who redeems, the one that delivers, the one that sets free, the one that brought you here this morning, the one that has kept you all week. The one that gave you the movement of your limbs. The one that allowed you to have breath this morning. The one that allowed you to be able to walk through these doors. Nobody had to push you. Nobody had to put you in a wheelchair and push you in. You've got the movement of your limbs. He's a wonderful God, I say. He's an amazing King. He's a wonderful Savior. He's a wheel in the middle of the wheel. He's wonderful. He's almighty. He's omniscient. I wish I could find a praiser that will join me in testifying of the goodness of God. Come on, open your mouth and give your God a great big praise. Hallelujah. You are wonderful, God. You are wonderful, 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 wonderful. And I bless you, you're wonderful, and I exalt you're wonderful, and I give you glory, you're wonderful, and I give you praise, you're wonderful, and I magnify your name, you're wonderful, so I lift you up, you're wonderful, so I magnify, I glorify, I exalt you, I magnify you, I give your name the glory, I give your name the honor, I give your name the praise, because you're wonderful, you're mighty. You're all powerful. You know everything about me. So I give it all to you. I give it all to you. I give it all to you. Everything that's in me gives your name the glory. With everything I have, with everything I am, I give it all to you. I came through the doors with a heart of thanksgiving. I came through the doors ready to give you my sacrifice of praise. So God, here it is. Receive my worship. Receive my worship. Receive my praise. Receive all the glory and all the honor. Hallelujah. Oh, glory.
Woo! Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes.
The psalmist David says, one thing that I desired of the Lord, that one thing is what I'm going to seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord. And it doesn't necessarily mean the physical house. It means his presence, that I may dwell in the presence of the Lord when all the days of my life. That's where I want to be. I always want to be in his presence all the days of my life. Ooh, Jesus. To behold the beauty of the Lord. Do you know that he's beautiful? And to inquire in his temple. And in order for him to do that, in order for us to dwell in the presence of the Lord all the days of our lives, he must arise within us. He must arise around us. He must arise all through us. And so it's our prayer today that the Lord God Almighty, that he arise. Let God arise. Let God arise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many of you want him to arise in your life today? Do you want him to arise in your life today? Hallelujah. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we honor you. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We love you, Lord God. We thank you, Jesus. We give you
come on. One thing that I, one thing that I.
God.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, church, open your mouth and give God the praise.
Hallelujah.
Come on, bless him.
Right.
Come on and bless him. Come on and bless him. Hallelujah. We magnify your name, God. And we just want you to know how much we love you. We want you to know how much we adore you. We want you to know how much we give your name the praise and we magnify you. Hallelujah. We look to you. We look to you.
God, I look to you. I won't be overwhelmed. Give me a vision to see things like you do. God, I look to you. You're where my help comes from. Give me wisdom, for you know just what to do. You're the almighty and all-powerful God.
Hallelujah, come on.
God, I look to you.
God, I look to you.
I won't be overwhelmed.
No matter what's going on around me, I won't let it take me over. Just allow me to see things the way you see them.
God, I look to you.
Because you're where my help comes from. Just give me wisdom, Lord God.
Give me wisdom.
You know just what to do.
You know just what to do, yeah.
Now come on, lift him up, lift him up, lift him up. Lift your hands before the Lord. As we declare, I will love you, Lord. Come on and sing it from your spirit.
I will love you.
I will love you.
Praise, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, our God reigns.
Come on and testify, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, our God reigns.
Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
and ever.
Hallelujah.
Forever and ever. Forever and ever. My praise will be.
Somebody lift up a praise to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I know it's easy to clap. It's easy to clap.
Hallelujah.
But here's what I need you to do. I need you to open your mouth.
Hallelujah.
And let the Lord hear the praise come from your lips. Let the declaration come from your lips. Let him know, forever all my days, I will praise you, Lord. With every breath I take, with every move I make, I will praise you, Lord. With everything that's in me, you will get a hallelujah out of me. No matter what it looks like, you will get a hallelujah out of me. Wherever I go, you will get a hallelujah out of me. No matter what I face, you will get a hallelujah out of me. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, you will get a hallelujah out of me. When I don't know what else to say, when I don't know where else to turn, you will get a hallelujah out of me. Whatever the doctor's report may be, you will get a hallelujah out of me. Whatever goes on in my life, you will get a hallelujah out of me. Whatever's going on in my home, you will get a hallelujah out of me. Whatever's going on my job, you will get a hallelujah out of me. I can't say it for you. You've got to say it for yourself. So let the Lord hear you. Let him hear you. Let him hear you. Let the Lord hear you today. Cut the music. Now let the sound of praise arise in this house. Let the sound of praise and worship arise in this house. Let the sound of adoration arise in this house. Let the sound of exaltation arise in this house. Send your worship to him as a sweet smelling savor to his nostril. Ask him to receive it. Ask him to receive it. Ask him to receive it. Young and old, lift your hands before the Lord. Lift your hands before the Almighty God and give your God a great big praise, for he's worthy of it. Come on, open your mouth, church. Hallelujah. We magnify you, Lord. Yes, God. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Glory, 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 Lord. We exalt your mighty name. We magnify you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our God reigns. 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 Help me sing it, our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
Our God reigns.
From the hills to the valleys, our God reigns. Oh, our God reigns. Sing it one more time, our God. Let him reign in your life.
My God.
Oh, let him have his way.
My God.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does. Our God reigns. Now, as I was singing that, the Holy Spirit says, not only do I reign as a king, but I R-A-I-N as well. And so if you want the reign of the Lord, I want you to declare that he reigns.
He reigns.
He's getting ready to reign in this house this morning. And if you need some of those drops, this is a good time to lift your hands. It may not be in the right key, but you just sing it wherever you can sing it. Because our God is about to reign on us. I declare it and I speak it. It's going to happen. So with your faith and my faith, I'm going to let you sit down in a minute. We're going to work this out. But let's lift our voices for the last time. Sing it like a trumpet. Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Yes, he does. Our God reigns. Our God reigns.
Our God reigns. Our God reigns.
Hallelujah. 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 Our God reigns. Now you sing it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It's called prophetic worship. You're saying just what he wants to hear. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Hallelujah. Clap your hands and give the reigning God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, clap your hands. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, Minister Des. Thank you, Minister Lillian and the praise team. Clap your hands, oh ye people. You may be seated for a moment and shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Good morning, Golden Gates. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Look at the person on your right and on your left and tell them it's good to see you. Come on, make sure you look at someone and tell them it's good to see you. Hallelujah. God has been so good. And because you can be seen, that's a good reason to give him praise. Certainly want to keep the Brown family in our prayers. We buried Elder Brown on Friday, and keep Sister Patricia Kelly Brown in your prayers. We also want to thank you on behalf of Sister Marilyn Ward Kemp, who's standing at the door. The cookout yesterday for Matthew was a tremendous success, and we certainly want to thank you for your help. Next Sunday is Independence Sunday. And so in addition to dressing down for the months of July and August, we're also going to be wearing our Bahamian colors next week. And you don't want to miss service on Independence Sunday. Then also we want to remind you that this evening at, what time is the concert this evening for Bishop Henschel? 5 p.m. at Bahamas Faith Ministries. Just want to make that announcement. We love Bishop Henschel and we're praying for him. He's going through a battle of cancer, but our God can do anything. Anything. Say anything. Anything. He can do anything. He can do anything. What do you need him to do? He can do what? That just hit me in my spirit. So we want to pray for the Henschel family. He went through surgery this week. The Lord brought him through that surgery. Tonight will be a time of honoring for him at 5 p.m. And certainly, even if you can't make it there, pray. And if you can, lend a financial hand. Our church has already been doing things to, we've done several blessings, and we're going to continue to do that for Bishop Henschel. But certainly, if there's something that you want to earmark for him, if you can't get it to him, get it to our office, and we will be sure that he gets it. So happy to have our commissioner in the house. Can we bless the Lord for the commish? Amen. I always feel a little safer. Somebody in here got a gun. Amen. And we give great honor and deference to our spiritual leader, our chief, in the person of Archbishop Ross Davis and Lady Davis. Can we clap our hands and celebrate them? Hallelujah. Say, we love you, Bishop. Hallelujah. And say, we love you, First Lady, because she needs the love too. Amen. Love the First Lady. And certainly, the commissioner has a wife. Yes, he does. Can we bless the Lord for the commissioner's wife? That's my friend. You see where she is. She with you. Amen. 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 Certainly, we thank God for Lady Novia in her absence. Let's look now to the word of the Lord coming from Luke chapter number 7 on this wonderful first Sunday in July. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad you made it over the first half? Hallelujah. The enemy had to take you out in January and February. Hallelujah. Every time you cough, you wonder if you have it. Hallelujah. If you wonder if you're getting it again. But even if you had it, God held it down. I don't hear nobody. I say, even if you had it, it didn't take you out. So whatever you did in the first half, it's time to intensify that for the second half. Because the devil is mad already. Hallelujah. How many came to hear a word from the Lord today? Y'all stand to your feet one more time as we honor the word. We got to read it, and then I'll allow you to sit. So grateful for Sister Brene Clark. Yesterday we had over 200 young women here in a young ladies conference. And the virtuous daughters and our very own Brene Clark led a team through here. I wish you could see them. We're going to put the pictures up. There's the picture yesterday. Come on, clap, y'all. Look at all those people in your church yesterday. So while you were doing your shopping, we were here having church. I had a marvelous, marvelous time. Amen. I see Red Eye is in the house. Terrence Red Eye McSweeney, longtime member of the church. God bless you. Still a member. Once a member, always a member. You were a member in Bishop Eyes. Guess what? If you cough too hard, Bishop coming to get you. Amen. Glad to have you in service. Listen now to the word of the Lord. Luke chapter 7, verses 36 through 39. I'll preach and sit down. And one of the Pharisees desired him, Jesus, that he would eat with him. Pharisee wanted Jesus to come to dinner. And when Jesus went into the Pharisee's house and sat down to meet to dinner, the Bible says, and behold, a woman in the city which was a sinner. When she knew that Jesus sat at meat in the Pharisee's house, she brought an alabaster box of ointment. Verse 38, and stood at his feet behind him weeping, began to wash his feet with her tears, and did wipe them with the hairs of her head, and kissed his feet, and anointed them with the ointment. Last verse. Now, when the Pharisee, which had bidden him, the Pharisee that had invited him to dinner in the first place, when he saw it, he spake within himself. He didn't talk out loud. He thought it. He said, this man, if he was a real prophet, he would have known who and what manner of woman this is that's touching him. For she is a sinner. So, Father, scripture text, and before you take your seat, Sister Prasanti, do me a favor and help me preach my text to the person standing on your right and left. I want to preach today from the subject, let me explain something to you. Look at the person next to you, tell them, let me explain something to you. You ain't say that like you're from the Bahamas, man. Look at something, let me explain something to you. That's a daisy line. Father, send your anointing. Send your power. In the name of Jesus, we pray. You all have your seat. Let me explain something to you. Whenever Dynamite Daisy says, let me explain something to you, she coming at you through a side door to break something down that you should understand, but clearly you're missing. In my introduction, I'll get straight to it. This is what we would entitle a strange invitation. You ever got a strange invitation? Every now and then, someone that is on an opposing side to you invites you to dinner or does some kind of gesture that makes it seem like they're warming up to you. Have you ever had someone warm up to you? Well, when you know who you are, you can go anywhere by yourself and still be who you are. Somebody said birds of a feather flock together. Yes, but certain birds could fly with other birds and still be themselves. So Jesus finds himself at the house of the Pharisee. And just as shocking as the invitation was, I am sure the Pharisee thought to himself, I'm going to invite him just to see what he's going to say. But just as shocking as the invitation was as shocking as the acceptance was. Never put Jesus to a test that you don't think he can pass. So Jesus finds himself now in the living room of this Pharisee. He's sitting to the table and he's living out the hymn, rescue the perishing, care for the dying. For Jesus is merciful and Jesus will save. You see, the Pharisees were a specialized group of people. They were on the legal side of Judaism. The rules, they understood the rules, Minister Gloria. You got to do this and you got to do that. Not that they're keeping any of the rules themselves, but they were the rule keepers. And they were the police of the church. They were the church police. Your skirt too short. And yours too long. Your hair shouldn't be this way. And you shouldn't wear that. We got to do this. These were the pharisaical voices that came about during Jesus' day. And just in case you're not sure how Jesus felt about them, Jesus sends a whole discourse out in Matthew 23, verses 1 through 39. And he says, woe unto the Pharisees and to the scribes. For Jesus was never afraid to confront the spirit that rules in men. The Bible says, don't follow their teaching because they will not practice what they teach. They tie up heavy burdens and make it hard to bear. And they lay them, these are Jesus' words, on the shoulders of others. But they themselves are unwilling to lift a finger to move them. Jesus, when speaking of the Pharisees, he said they do all their deeds to be seen by others. They wear their robes long and they have to have the place of honor at banquets and the best seats in the synagogue. This Jesus talking. Anytime I speak and it's not in the word, then you got to pull me back. They have the best place of honor at the banquets and the best seats in the synagogues and to be greeted with respect in the marketplaces, and they make people call them rabbi. Jesus says in verse number 13, woe unto you scribes and Pharisees. In the same text that we're looking at right here in Luke chapter number 7, in verse 30 it says, but the Pharisees and the lawyers rejected the counsel of God against themselves. So here's Jesus in direct opposition to the Pharisees, yet the Pharisees invite him to dinner and Jesus accepts the invitation. I want you to know you can survive, point number one, you can survive anywhere with Jesus if Jesus is with you. I said you can survive on your job if you got Jesus. You can be a Christian in your family reunion if you got Jesus. You could be a saved in the food store, wherever you go, if Jesus goes with me, the songwriter says, I'll go. And I want to challenge some of you that are afraid to ever go into enemy territory. If you have the light, and if we are the salt of the world, how will the light penetrate the darkness if all the light do is stay around the light? Maybe this is some kind of indication of how our evangelistic thrust ought to be. Because Jesus was not afraid of what people would say when they found out he went to the Pharisee's house for dinner. He had a greater agenda that was beyond what people thought of him. There are some people that God will send in your life and you will encounter them. And sometimes you got to go on their turf to win them to yours. Y'all ain't hearing me today. You cannot be so sanctified. You cannot be so out of the way and so special till you cannot go over onto the enemy's camp to do God's business. Bible says, now when the Pharisee, the one that invited him, verse number 39, had bidden him and saw him, he spoke with him himself, within himself, saying, this man can be a prophet. Because if he knew this man was a prophet, if he was a real prophet, this woman that's coming into the picture, something is wrong. He would have rejected her. My goodness. Psalm 34 says, he heals the brokenhearted. He is near. He is near to those who are brokenhearted. It means God has an affinity for things that are broken. In a society where everything has to be fixed, in a society where that demands perfection, you ought to be glad that God deals with broken situations, broken marriages, and broken people. That's a good place to clap. I know you don't want nobody to know you were ever broken before because you mended and you look perfect. But how many knows God deals with broken pieces? That's what Lenora Taylor used to sing. Pick up the broken pieces and do what? Bring them to the Lord. So now there's this woman going on. And it's strange to me that how this woman gets in here. Number one, she's a woman. How's she get in this man's house? You ever ask yourself that? How did this woman get in? And this ain't no ordinary man's house. He got servants. He got people to the door. If I know him, he lived behind the gate and got a little security boot to the gate. You understand? Sometimes they build them house and can't pay for the security, but they just want you to take somebody in there. How she got in the house? She's a woman and she's a known sinner. And when you see that word known sinner, that is the Bible's nice way of saying she's a little hooker. She's a prostitute. She's a woman on the street and everybody knows it. She dresses in such a way that people know what her business is all about. How did she get past security? How did she know that Jesus would be there? Could this be a setup? The Bible says, and stood at his feet, this is the woman now, behind him weeping, and she began to wash his feet with tears, and did wipe them with the hairs of her head, and kissed his feet. And the ointment that was with him, that ointment, that alabaster box, it was made of marble, y'all. It was a nice box. Somehow she had one. May I put to you that this was a setup indeed. It's a setup. Look at the neighbor next to you and tell him God is setting you up. It was not a setup by the Pharisee. He ain't that smart. But it was a setup by God himself. This lady was a breakaway worshiper. Let me say that again. This lady was a breakaway worshiper. She was a follower of Christ. And in following him, she watched to see where he went. And she saw him go into the Pharisee's house. She said, I'm going to wait out here till he come. Because I want to worship him some more. I want to wait out here. And it seemed like he'd been in there a long time. And I got this alabaster box. Listen, I don't care what I got to do. All I know, I got to find myself inside to where he is. I wonder if that's five or six of y'all here that you just decided today, no matter what's trying to hold me back this morning, the clothes ain't working out. I can't find something to match. I can't get my hair together. I can't get my clothes together. The car is acting crazy. It may be raining outside. I might have to catch the bus. But if Jesus is in there, I don't care where that is. I got to find him. And until you get to that place in your worship,
you will never experience the exponential love of God. You will never experience the supernatural. This woman was hungry for God's presence. She was hungry to be where Jesus was. And if Jesus was behind that door, it didn't matter who was standing to the door. She was going to find a way to get in. And that's how you have to be when you come on Sunday. There's so many blocks to your praise. There's so many things hindering how you're going to be blessed. But you got to make up your mind. If this strange woman could get into a Pharisee house that she has never been before and find herself at the foot of Jesus, why is it that you could walk into this house with no security guard and know Jesus is in here and you still not be at his feet? This woman can teach us a lesson that I don't come here, I don't care, come hell or high water, I got to praise him. I can't stay away out of his presence too long. I gotta have my Jesus fix. I got to have me some worship. And I tell people all the time, you got to calendar and schedule. You got time for everything else. Where are the people that say when a certain time come, baby, I got to hang up the phone. I got to turn off the TV, because this is my time to spend in the presence of a living God. If you want to see miracles, if you want to see your life blessed, you got to get to the place where you press your way in. I press. Now, where are the 50 of you that got enough praise left to jump on your feet and clap your hands and open up your mouth and press your way past security, press your way past tradition, press your way past your tiredness, press your way past your insecurity? David said it this way: I'll bless the Lord at all times, and his praise. Y'all sit down. Let me read this little essay. Hallelujah to Jesus. She got to get inside. When she gets there, she's not on no observation trip. She's not coming to write down notes. She's not coming to interview the Pharisee. She's not coming to take the decor down and to see if the lampshade matched the drapes. No, sir. When she gets there, she gets right to praising him. She gets right to Jesus' feet. And the problem with some of us is when we get in the house of the Lord, we don't get right to his feet. We get distracted by the other people at the dinner. We get distracted by the things that's going on in the room. But I dare you one Sunday, when you come in here, put your imagination to be right at the feet of Jesus before the praise and worship start, before they even get to that place. You get in the service and you pull out your alabaster box and you start pouring on your praise. You start pouring on your thank yous. That woman should have been out of her mind. All the things that she had been through, she should have been convalescing in the old folks' home or the crazy house. But she realized, if I have a little bit of praise left, if I got a little bit of worth left, I'm going to place it at the Lord's feet. And the Bible said, when she did that, she broke out her alabaster box. Point number two, listen to what happens now. The Bible says in verse 39, that when the Pharisee had seen what the woman had done, he spoke within himself, and he said, if this man was a real prophet, he wouldn't have let her come close to him. Point number two, when you worship like that, somebody gonna have a problem with your praise. When you get up out your seat and you can't sit down, somebody gonna have a problem. When you dancing like y'all dance and you ain't a part of the liturgical ministry, somebody gonna have a problem. And that's what happened here. This man here, he invited Jesus and he had a chance to worship him, but he had a problem with her worship. Sisters and brothers, we still got that spirit in the church. Instead of you try to get through as best as you could get through, you so busy observing how this one praising, whether this one is quiet, whether this one is standing up. Maybe this one is quiet today because this guy one got something on their mind, or they're praising him under their breath. I don't care how you praise him, whether you praise him loud or whether you praise him soft. My problem is when you try to hinder mine, I ain't gonna hinder yours. But do, for Jesus' sake, you have no idea why I'm at his feet. You have no idea what I had to do to save up to get this much. My, somebody gonna have a problem But even though he was the Lord of the house, even though the Pharisee owned the house, the woman said, I'm here now, and since I'm here, I got to worship. If you want me out this house, you're going to have to pry me from Jesus. And the problem with some of y'all, y'all let go of the master too quick. Where are the folk that'll say, I got to praise him, whether you approve or not, whether you like me or not, I got to praise him. I rose up to praise him. It may not be your house. I may be a guest in here. But while I'm in here, I decided I'm going to shift the atmosphere in the Pharisee house. And that's what you got to learn how to do when you get into strange territory. Your praise can shift the atmosphere even on strange ground. And what I don't understand is if her praise could shift the atmosphere in the enemy's camp, why is it that your praise can't shift the atmosphere in the friendly camp? It's because you ain't praising him enough. It's because you don't want to see a shift. But I believe there are 50 of us that didn't come for service as usual. I didn't bathe my skin and wash my face to come here and watch TV. But I came to give him glory and I came to give him honor. Where are the 50 of y'all that say, I don't care if the Pharisee object, I'm going to stay to his feet. I don't care if they call me crazy, I'm going to stay at his feet. I don't care if they say I'm losing my mind, I'm going to lose my mind at his feet. Where are the folk that know what feet smell like? It is the footsteps of Jesus that I am following after. And some of y'all can't get this because you scared of feet. Some of y'all can't get this because you too squirmish. My, sisters and brothers, even though you have objectors, you got to worship him like you know what God has done for you. Let me move on. And the Bible said, Jesus turned to the woman and said unto Simon, you see this woman, I came in your house. You didn't give me no water for my feet. You didn't wash my feet with your tears. You didn't wipe them. You didn't give me no water. You didn't give me no kiss. And you didn't give me no oil. You didn't give me no water. You didn't give me no kiss. And you didn't give me no oil. Could it be that the thing that God has against you is you came into the house? He came into the presence, but you didn't give him no oil, and you didn't give him no kiss, and you didn't give him no water. The water is your praise, and he's in the house. My question to you, if Jesus is in your house, he's right in here now, how could you have the water and not offer him none? How could you have the oil and keep it in your pocket? How could you fold your lips and not kiss the man who woke you up this morning, who started you on your way? How could you be common with the man that was so awesome? And the problem with the Pharisee is he thought because Jesus came to his house, he was on the same level of Jesus. And the thing that he would not do is the thing that he got mad for somebody else doing. How you gonna get mad at me for being kind to my neighbor when you choose to be mean? How you gonna get mad at me for lending them money when you choose to hold yours in your pocket? How you gonna get mad at me when I give sister so-and-so a ride and you pass them straight? My, the indictment of not only doing it yourself, you didn't do it yourself, but you don't want nobody to do it. And that's what we got in the church today. I don't want to serve, and I don't want nobody else to serve. I don't want to praise him. Y'all can sit there. I woke up early this morning for this. I don't want to praise him, and I don't want you to praise him either. I don't want you to bless the pastor, and I ain't going to bless him neither. That's a spirit that is creeping in the church. I'm miserable, so I want you to be miserable too. That's what the Pharisee was saying. I'm treating him common, so you treat him common too. I'm acting like he's just my friend, so you treat him like he's just your friend. And I believe in the spirit. That woman said, I can't act like he's common. I can't treat him like he's regular. When I was down, and out. He lifted me up when I couldn't find myself. When folk were talking about me and calling me prostitute and whore and slut. When he looked in my eyes, he didn't want my body, but he wanted my heart. So you can act like he's coming if you want to, but I serve a risen Savior. He's in the world today. Wherever man is living, whatever man may say, I see his hand of mercy. I hear his voice of joy. I feel the preacher coming. And just the time I need him, he's always there. Where are the folk that'll say he lives? He lives. Christ Jesus lives today. How do you know, Pastor Trent? How? Because he walks with me and he talks with me and he tells me I am his own. And because he walks with me and because he lives, I can face tomorrow. And because he lives, all fear is gone. So when I get into his presence, I don't ask him how his mother doing. When I get into his presence, I don't ask him where he live. When I get into his presence, I humble myself, lift up both my hands, and I begin to worship him. Where are the worshipers that have decided today, I'm going to make today a little special. I'm going to give him a little extra, because he woke me up and started me on the way. I felt like I was going to give up this week, but he gave me a little bit more to press on. I had a headache and a backache. I had a toothache and a side ache. But the healer came by, even without me praying, and touched my infirmity. Where are the folk that say, I gotta give him a little extra this week? My child was acting crazy on Monday, but by Saturday they told me they were sorry. Where are the folk that say, I got to give him just a little bit more than this? Give him just a little bit more than this. Hallelujah to Jesus. Hallelujah to Jesus. Now listen to this. And I'm going to turn this dangerous curve. And I'm going to get on out your way. And the Bible says, don't let people draw you into their misery. Because the Pharisee don't want to praise him. Because the Pharisee don't want to treat him like he should be. That woman wasn't checking for him. Because I know who Jesus is. Touch three people around you. Tell them I know who he is. I ain't got to ask nobody. I know what he means to me. And the Bible said that Jesus looked at the woman and said unto her, thy sins are forgiven. And he looked at her again in verse number 50 and said, thy faith has saved thee. Go in peace. So now she got three words. She wasn't invited to the service. She wasn't even on the roster. But because she saw Jesus go in, she followed him to worship him. And now she got three words in one day. The words were, you're forgiven, your faith has saved thee, and you got peace to go in. I want to talk to somebody. When you praise God like that, he will forgive your sins. When you praise God like that, he will save you in the time of adversity. But when you praise God like that, he will hush the voices of your enemies in your ear, and he'll give you peace in the midst of them talking. He'll give you peace in the midst of them plotting. He'll give you peace in the midst of them planning. Where are the folk that'll say, I should be out of my mind, but I got a peace that I can't explain. It didn't go quite like I thought it would. I still had to have the operation, but I still got a peace. They still put me out the house, but I still got a peace. I lost a job anyhow, but I still got a peace. I wish 50 of y'all would jump up on your feet and say, I still got my peace. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't you worry about me. I got my peace. Don't you sit up there thinking he ain't gonna hold it together. I got a peace, the peace that the world didn't give, and the world can't take it away. I'll keep you in perfect peace. All you gotta do is follow me in the house and keep your mind. When the Pharisee jump up, you stay down. When the Pharisee talk up, you stay down. When the Pharisee starts moving up, you shut up. You just go to praising him, calling him worthy, calling him thank you, telling him thank you, tell him you love him. Shout hallelujah up in this house. Now. I sent Clint Watson out to interview this woman. When she came out of the house, he said to her, how you got in these people's house? Did you break in? She said, let me explain something to you. Jesus, let me explain something to you, because maybe you're not getting this. Let me just break this down to you. My name is Mary Magdalene, and I had 7 demons inside me. One for every day of the week. It tormented me on Monday. It stretched me on Tuesday. Gave me a headache on Wednesday. Crippled me up so I couldn't walk on Thursday. On Friday, I couldn't see. On Saturday, I couldn't hear. Because when you have demons, you have all the sicknesses combined. When you have demons, you got depression and all the stuff that comes with that. When you have demons, you have financial ways that you cannot make. For demons is a compilation of financial problems, medical problems, and emotional problems. The devil had done her right in. And now for the first time, she know Monday from Tuesday. From the first time, she could look at those men in their faces that used to use her for money, that came back for a second round. She could look at them and say, not today, baby. You will get to a place where you can look the devil in his eye and say, not today. I remember when I was growing up, I had an aunt that used to like to buy number. But when certain people was in the house and the number man came around, she would lean out the window and say, not today, baby. And that meant come back around 2 o'clock. Hallelujah. But when you get to the place in your life when you can say, not today, devil, you say it on Monday, not today. You come back on Tuesday, you say, not today. You come back on Wednesday and you say, not today. Because the Bible said if you resist the devil, he will flee from you. Where are the folk that are resisting him? Sisters and brothers, as I hastened to my seat, she was interviewed by Clint Watson. She came in with one agenda, and she had to show him her gratitude. Now I leave you with this. Wait, hold on, Pastor Trent. Something wrong. Something ain't right. Jesus told her, your sins are forgiven, your faith has saved you, go in peace. If Jesus told her that then, why was she worshiping before? Let me say that again. Jesus said, your sins be forgiven, go in peace, you're saved. Why would Jesus tell her that if she just kneeled down off the street? I didn't understand that. Put up verse number 39 for me. I want to show you something. Now when the Pharisee which had bidden him, had invited him, saw it, he spake within himself, saying, this man, if he were a prophet, he would have known who and what manner of woman this is that toucheth him. For, read these last 5 words, for she is a... Okay, so that's his confession. The Pharisee man say, she is a sinner. Now go and put up Luke verse number 37. Verse number 37. And behold, this is Luke talking. A woman in the city which was. Hold on. Luke say, when she came in, she was a sinner. The Pharisee, when he saw her, say she is a sinner. Now, what's going on here is she has already changed, and he don't know. Because in his mind, he got to get the memo of who God's saving and when he's saving them. And that's how y'all act. Y'all act like God got to tell you. The Bible says, and we sing a song, you don't know when God and sinner reconcile. The truth of the matter, it was a setup from the beginning. Hear me, in the realm of the spirit. When Mary came in there, she had already met Jesus before that. And her space and her faith, and he had already done it for her. He had already saved her in private. And so since the man invited Jesus, my God, to his house, the Bible says later on that all of them marveled. It means it wasn't just one Pharisee there. When he invited Jesus, he told his boys, you know how we do. When you get somebody important coming to your house, you tell your close friends who your associates are. Man, you better come on and be there, because I can interview Jesus. And you got to hear what he got to say. So Jesus used the occasion of being invited in the presence of all of those Pharisees in the public to do something for this woman in public. What he had already done in private, he had already saved her, he had already set her free, but the world didn't know her. They still saw her as a sinner. So what Jesus did, he arranged to go to the man house. Mary followed him in, and when Jesus finished pronouncing over Mary, he was saying in the presence of all of the naysayers, he was saying in the presence of all of the people that said she could not be nothing, what I'm doing for you, and your private praise, your private worship, your private love for me, I'm getting ready to send you public. I'm getting ready to let the world know who you are. And from that point on, Mary Magdalene stopped being known as the woman that was filled with seven demons, but she became known as the best friend of Jesus Christ. Jesus will do with you in the public what you do with him in private. And maybe it could be that folk don't know what's happening with you in public, because ain't nothing happening with you in private. But I serve a God, when you serve him in private, when you own him before him in the closet, he'll bring you out in the open. I came to tell somebody on my way to my seat, let me explain something to you. God is getting ready to put such an anointing on your life. God is getting ready to usher you into another dispensation of power that every pharisaical voice, every enemy will have to recognize that there is a God in you. I'm finished. Hallelujah. Listen, she was already saved. There's some people who you're looking at, you think they ain't gonna never be nothing. But what you don't all know is God has already changed them. What you don't know is the person that you're judging does not exist anymore. And if God can't change her, then how are you going to change you? Get out of that pharisaical spirit where you observe how everybody worships. I watched some old videotape of Golden Gates this week. There were some of you, as soon as the band played, you would be running across here. And now, Sunday after Sunday, you holding on to your chair like you on Space Mountain. You wouldn't move to save your life. You sit right at the table like a Pharisee. And then when somebody catch the Holy Ghost, you say, why is she doing that? We ain't shouting in this season. We watching. We ain't shouting in this season. We holding back our praise. Like you could hold something back from God. You could afford to do that? I challenge you to break that alabaster box open. What is interesting, and I'm finished. Everyone standing. That man, the Pharisee, he was so rich. He could afford plenty alabaster boxes. Jesus pulled him aside and told him a story. I don't want you to miss this. There was a man. This is the story Jesus told. He said one man needed to borrow some money. I can make it, bring it into the current time. He ran to Jesus and said, Jesus, I need $50, man, because I break. I can need $10 to buy some lunch every day. So Jesus say, okay, here that $50. I'm coming back for payday for that. There was another man, and that's a real $50. Bring the camera close now. There's five $100 bills. This is an illustration. Don't get no ideas. This man came running up and said, my son is sick. He need an operation. Cost $500. Jesus said, here, do the operation. And pay they come and get that back from you. And pay they came. Jesus went back to the guy. Say, I know you to eat lunch. You look a little full. Where my money? The man say he had the money. Jesus said, you stay right there, coming back. You borrow my $500. Where's my money? Both of them didn't have the money, just in case you think you're special. Jesus said to them, now which one you think should be praising me? He say, I forgive you. You ain't got to pay it back. It's only a little bit of lunch money. This man over here, because of what Jesus did for him, his child is alive. And that $500 can be hard to come by. And Jesus say, don't worry about it. You ain't got to pay me back. Which one you think will be jumping up and down, Jesus says. The one who I forgave most. Now, what I don't understand with some of y'all is, does your praise look like this? Or does your praise look like this? When you come up in here, you ought to lose your mind. Because listen, you owe him $500. You owe him $50 billion. The Pharisee learned a valuable lesson that day. That my praise is commensurate to how much I've been forgiven. Every hand is lifted and your eyes are closed. I want you to thank him for forgiving you of that big $500 debt. Everybody should be praising him. Everybody should be thanking him. God, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. You could have taken us in for that $50. You could have sent us off to jail and you would have had every right to charge us. But God, you forgave the debt. So now since we have you at dinner, we worship you. We praise you and we adore you. Help us, God, to remember this day so that when we come in here, we don't give you no 50-cent praise on a $500 gift. It's an insult to who you are. Father, forgive us. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Everyone say amen. If you were blessed by the word today, clap your hands. Come on, clap them loud. Clap them loud. You may be seated in his presence. Hallelujah. Our ushers are coming, getting ready to bless the Lord with this morning's tithes and offering.
A marvelous time we've had in worship today. It seems like every Sunday, the time goes by quicker and quicker. It is our prayer here at Golden Gates that you are blessed today, not only by the sung word, but by the spoken word. The word that was just shared, let that bless you in your spirit. Well, perhaps you're here today and you've been watching the broadcast. It may be your first time or you've seen us several times and you're not a member of the body of Christ. We'd like to invite you to become a Christian today. If that is your desire, sir or ma'am, please just repeat this simple prayer after me. Dear Father God, I am a sinner in need of a Savior. Come into my life and change me, I pray. In the name of Jesus, amen. Well, my brother or my sister, if you prayed that prayer today, it is my pleasure to welcome you into the family of God. And I think the next step should be to join a Bible-based believing church. And I think Golden Gates would just be the perfect choice. The choice is yours, but if you'd like to partner with us, whether online, virtually, if you're anywhere in the world, or here in sunny Nassau, Bahamas, just let us know. It'll be our pleasure to serve you and to be your pastor and to have our church family to be your church family. Well, with all this excitement in the air, I'd like for you to just give us a few more minutes, stay tuned, and watch these announcements.
Good morning, Golden Gates. My name is Brittany Coakley, and these are your news and announcements for this week. This Sunday was Communion Sunday, and we pray that you were enlightened by the service and that your experience today was a golden one. Now here are your weekly reminders to help you stay connected with us throughout the week.
On Monday nights, we have intercessory prayer with Archbishop Ross Davis and Pastor Trent Davis at 8 o'clock p.m. On Thursday nights, we have Bible study with Pastor Trent Davis at 8 o'clock p.m. on the church's Facebook page. And it's all going down every Friday night at the Bay. 8 o'clock p.m. to 9:30 p.m. Talk shows, talent jams, interactive Bible studies, and competitive game nights. It's where the young people live. So don't meet us there, beat us there. Join us for 1 hour of prayer every Saturday from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. here in the sanctuary. We are updating our church's database here at the gates. So we encourage all of our members, new and old, to provide us with your current information by filling out one of our new membership forms. Please speak with one of our ushers so that you can complete and return the form updated with your date of birth, current address, and contact information.
Lights, camera, and action. The Golden Gates Youth Concert Band presents a musical experience like none you've ever heard before. Under the theme, A Night of Movies, on July 18th at 6:30 p.m. Tickets will be on sale at a cost of $20 for adults and $10 for students 12 and under. So please, you don't want to miss out.
The wait is finally over. The Golden Gates Praise Team and Friends Independence Day Gospel Tribute will air this Saturday, July 10th at 8 o'clock p.m. So share with your friends and family members and help us get the word out as we all tune in together and celebrate 48 years of independence. We would like to say congratulations to the following persons. Andre Davis on graduating from C.L. Walker Senior High School. Alanis Gardner for making not only the honor roll, but the dean's list with a GPA of 3.93 this semester at Queens College. Your mom, your grandmom, and the Bay family is so proud of you. To Miss Benjanique Miller on graduating with honors at St. Augustine's College and obtaining a 3.87 GPA. And to Elnice Johnson, graduating from Mount Carmel Preparatory School with honors in physics, chemistry, civics, and a grade point average of 3.50. As you all continue this new journey, remember to keep God first in all that you do and to aim for the stars.
It's celebration time, and the leadership team here at the Gates would like to wish the following persons a happy birthday and a happy anniversary.
Donna Coakley, Kelson Taylor, Tariq Sands, Theo Clark, Paris Bethel, Jamari Sayers, Bruce Clark, and a happy anniversary to Mr. Jeffrey and Sophia Ferguson, celebrating 20 years of marriage, and to our commissioner, Pastor Paul Roll, and his wife, Minister Terry Roll, on celebrating 33 years of marriage. May the light of God shine upon you and grant you continued happiness on your birthdays and anniversaries for many more to come. Our church is on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. To find us, type in Golden Gates World Outreach Ministries on Facebook and YouTube, and simply type Golden Gates Church on Instagram and look for our logo. If you want to be a part of the church's WhatsApp broadcast chat, where you will only receive information that's relevant to the church, just store the WhatsApp number, that's 434-6770, in your phone and send a WhatsApp text message saying, add me, and let the updates roll in.
Those were your news and announcements for this week. I am Brittany Coakley, and on behalf of our producers and the technical team here at the Gates News Studio and the leadership team here at the Gates, we wish you a blessed and a golden week ahead.
Well, thanks everybody for watching our news and announcements. Please govern yourselves accordingly. Our reporter, Sister Brittany Fountain Coakley, is so wonderful at what she does. We thank God for her every week. Well, our time has been wonderfully spent, and perhaps you'd like to sow into the ministry here at Golden Gates. Giving adds dimensions to your worship. I believe that the more seeds that you plant is the more opportunity that God has to bring about a harvest into your life. So if you'd like to give, there are three ways. You can give online and transfer funds from your account into our account, and that information at the First Caribbean Bank is appearing online right now. Or you can just drive by the church any day, Monday through Friday, between the hours of 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. Sow your gift. We will have somebody here ready to receive your gift and to pray with you and to bless you and to bless the financial aspects of your life. Or any Sunday morning, you can come and worship the Lord and at the appropriate time, bring your gifts to the Lord right here at the altar at the gates. But this is your season to sow, because after you sow, you will then reap. Well, our time has been wonderfully spent. I know that you have so many choices of places and broadcasts that you can watch, but week after week, you support us here at the gates. We thank you for that. We'll be back next week with another exciting word, marvelous music, and a prophetic utterance that will keep you going through 21. The best is yet to come, and until we meet next week, we'll see you again in the will of the Lord. Be blessed. I'm Pastor Trent, and I love you in Jesus' name.
Live event streaming provided by Church Boy Production Studio.